Okay, welcome everyone. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for coming to this presentation about how we can implement the Cert-manager in the Kubernetes platform. Basically, in this talk, I will try to explain, I will introduce the Cert-manager, how it works, and its implementation in Kubernetes as a native Kubernetes certificate management controller that allow us to manage the connection certificates and secure communications with through SSL and TLS protocols. First, I present myself. I'm from Spain. This year, I'm developer and security researcher at the university. And this year, for example, I have written and published a book relating with that has the title "Implementing DevSecOps with Docker and Kubernetes." Basically, in this book, you will learn about Docker and Kubernetes as a platform for the deployment of containers, taking into account the security of applications, basically. Also, there are chapters specific for securing your Docker and Kubernetes environments and discover vulnerabilities with and threats with specific tools like Falco, Trivi, and Kubebench. And also, there are specific chapters about monitoring and administration tools, with tools such as C-Advisor, Portainer, Rancher, Grafana, and Prometheus. Well, these are the main points of the talk. Between the points to be discussed, we can highlight, basically, we'll start with an introduction to what are the certificates and the certificates and the certification authorities, the CAs. Later, I will introduce the Cert-manager as a native Kubernetes certificate management controller. I will comment some features about Cert-manager, and in the last point, I will try to show some examples how we can integrate the Cert-manager with specific tools like Let's Encrypt or HashiCorp Vault. Well, what is a certificate? Well, basically, we have the concept of certification authority. That basically, a certification authority is an organization that allow us to validate the identities of entities such as websites, email addresses, and link them to a cryptographic keys by issuing digital certificates. Basically, a certificate is a digital certificate issued by a certificate authority, and basically the CA verifies certificates for trusted routes that are the foundation upon which chains of trust are built in certificates. Typically, an applicant for a digital certificate will generate the key pair consisting of a private key and a public key, along with a certificate signing request. Basically, this is the process. And after generating this certificate signing request, the requester submits this request to the CA, which verifies the information it contains that is. This information is correct, and if so, digitally syncs the certificates with an issue private key and send this to the requester. In most cases, what is used is a hierarchy of certificates to verify the validity of the issuer of a certificate, and this hierarchy is known as the chain of trust. Well, it's easy to see that of a chain of trust for yourself by inspecting a website certificate. When you check an SSL certificate in a web browser, you will find a breakdown of that digital certificate chain of trust, including the trust anchor, intermediate certificates, and the end entity certificates. And the following example shows the chain of trust for the ssl.com domain going from the entity website certificate to the root certification authority. When working with Kubernetes, the ingress basically is post a web application or a REST API within a cluster to the offsite. However, the application is reachable over HTTP by default, which is not secure, but since the traffic between the application and the client is not encrypted. At this point, the ingress can be configured to serve the application in HTTPS. This works like a reverse proxy by offloading this functionality from the application. To do this, you could configure a certificate in the ingress configuration file. However, the problems with this approach is that the certificate will not be trusted by default, and users will not, usually get a warning because of an invalid certificates. Well, the basic, when we are working with certificates, the basic requirement for ingress, TLS, you can obtain these certificates in the following ways. You can use a self-signature certificates. This is a certificate created and signed by our own certificate authority. The other option is purchase by a SSL certificate. And another option, for example, is using, for example, Less Encryption Certificate, that is a non-profit trusted certificate authority that provides free TLS certificates. For example, if we are working, if we're interested with Less Encrypt, basically is a certificate authority to enable HTTPS on your website, on your domain or your application. And in order to get a certificate for your website domain from Less Encrypt, you have to demonstrate or control over the domain. Less Encrypt basically Less Encrypt will look at the domain name being request and issue one or more set of challenge for the certificate. At this point, the certificate authority checks the challenge, checks that challenge have been satisfied and verifies the signature of the certificate. And in the last step, when Less Encrypt certificate authority receives the request from the user, it verifies both signatures. If everything looks good, it uses a certificate for the domain with the public key from the CCR and is returned to the agent, as I comment in before in the process. Well, in response to the need for TLS certificates, a Kubernetes controller called Cert-manager usually is used. Basically, the Cert-manager is a Kubernetes plugin or add-on to automate the management of TLS certificates from many issuing sources like Less Encrypt, for example, as I comment, or for example, also we can use, we are using, for example, HashiCorp Vault for managing the secrets of in Kubernetes. We can use also the solution. Well, in the RLS directory, in GitHub repository, we can see the different versions and the last stable version. This is continuous in deployment continuously. As I commented before, these are the main features of Cert-manager. It has the capacity to issue certificates from different issuers. And other characteristics like the Cert-manager, for example, has the capacity to act as a certificate authority. The own Cert-manager has the capacity. And also we can use, for example, if we use, for example, ACME protocol, also we can use this solution. At this point, I'm trying to explain the main objects that manage Cert-manager for working, for generating the certificates, and for making the request to the certificate authority for validating these certificates. The main concepts are the issuer and the or cluster issuers, depending what are our use case. Issuers and cluster users basically are objects in Kubernetes that represent certificate authorities that can generate single certificates. The other object is the certificate that is basically a namespace resource that references an issuer or cluster user. And will be basically this certificate will be renewed and keep up to date. And the last another interesting object is the certificate request. That is a namespace resource that is used to request a certificate from a user or cluster user. Well, in the context of Kubernetes, as I commented before, the certificate authority user represents the certificate authority whereby its certificate and private key are stored inside the cluster as a Kubernetes secret, for example, and will be used to send incoming certificate requests. This internal certificate can then be used to trust resulting signed certificates. This issuer tip, for example, is typical use in public key infrastructure setup to secure your infrastructure components to establish mutual TLS connections, which requires both server and client to verify these certificates. These are the steps we're going to follow for working with Cert-manager. I'm going to start from zero. First, we are going to start the Cert-manager. Later, we will create a cluster user to obtain certificates. For example, we are using Let's Encrypt for these tags. And finally, we will create a certificate request, and Cert-manager will create the TLS secret. Well, Cert-manager can be installed in different ways. The easy way, the most directly way, for example, we are using Help, for example, the Help package for installing the charts. We can use this package manager for installing Cert-manager. Basically, Help is a package manager that allows us to add applications to your cluster using repositories with pre-built charts. As we have mentioned before, Cert-manager is a Kubernetes service that provides TLS certificates from Let's Encrypt and other certification authorities. At this point, for example, we have available a command line tool for managing the resources lifecycle of for managing the lifecycle of our certificates. Another way of installing Cert-manager is using the YAML configuration file we can find in the Cert-manager GitHub repository. This is probably the most updated way because we are accessing directly to the source code of the Cert-manager and downloading this configuration file. And well, with this way, we can get the most updated Cert-manager. The first step at this point is create a namespace for Cert-manager. And the idea is that certificates can be requested and configured by applying the Cert-manager .io/issuer annotation. Now we will see this type on annotation. to ingress resources. Now we are going to, well, this is the output when executing the kubectl apply command. Basically, it's creating all custom resources definition, like pods and deployments. In this way, we will have a new object when installing, when executing this command. We will have a new object in Kubernetes that are the certificates. At this point, the certificates object are created in our environment, and we can use and we can manage the life cycle of these certificates. To verify our installation, we can check, for example, the pods that are running in Cert-manager set space. We can see that it's create three Cert-manager pods that we can check if they are running or not for verify the installation. When before continue with explaining how Cert-manager works, it's important differentiate between the issuers and cluster issuers. Before starting issuing certificates, we need to create an issuer. Why is important create? Because this issuer specify the certificates authority from which signed certificates can be obtained. And the next step is to create an issuer or cluster issuer to begin issuing certificates within your cluster. For example, Let's Encrypt Certificate Authority provides free TLS certificates. In the following examples, we will see that we are using Let's Encrypt Let's Encrypt for staging or production, for example. And we can use these free TLS certificates for testing your, for making, for example, a proof of content, a proof of concept, or testing your certificate setup in your environment. Well, this is the first how we can create this user. User, as I comment, are Kubernetes resources that represent the certificate authority, and are able to generate signed certificates by honoring certification in request. In this example, you can see the most simple certificate authority is user. Basically, we are specifying the API version and in the kind specify the issuer object. At this point, what are the differences between issuers and cluster issuers? Basically, the main difference is that issuers are namespaces, are created in a specific namespace. Resources and cluster issuer works for all namespaces in our cluster. This means that you will need to create an issuer in each namespace you wish to obtain certificates. In this example, for example, we are creating a cluster issuer object called Let's Encrypt Staging. That is using the Let's Encrypt staging server. And we also create a Kubernetes secret called Let's Encrypt staging private key to store the private key of the certificate. We can use the same, for example, if we need to work in the same configuration in production. Basically, we only need to change the Let's Encrypt name. Instead of using Let's Encrypt staging, we can use Let's Encrypt production in the metadata name. And with this change, we can use the same configuration, for example, for production. Well, with the previous file configuration, we can use this command for implement this cluster user using the kubectl command with the previous file configuration. At this point, we have created our cluster user, and the idea is to introduce the ingress controller. For example, we can use ingress in Nginx. That is an ingress controller for Kubernetes that use Nginx as a reverse proxy and load balancer. And one of the advantages of using ingress is its support for configuring SSL certificates in a simple way using Kubernetes objects. Well, for adding ingress TLS support, we need to create a Kubernetes secret certificate and a private key file. In this way, when you add TLS certificates to the ingress resource as a Kubernetes secret, the ingress controller access it and make it a part of its configuration. With the following command, for example, we can create a Kubernetes secret with server certificates. This certificate we need to generate this certificate, the server.crt certificate, and the server.key private key file. If we have this file generated, we can use this command for creating this Kubernetes secret. Well, the ingress resource that we have seen with TLS need to be created in the same namespace where the application has been deployed. Basically, you need to add the following configuration in the ingress configuration file. Now that we have created our Let's Encrypt test user, we are ready to modify the ingress resources and resource and enable TLS encryption. In this example, here we define the ingress controller as well as defining the cluster user to be Let's Encrypt staging. Finally, in the last section in this file, we add a TLS block in order to specify the domain for which we want to acquire certificates, and we specify a secret name. This secret will contain the TLS private key and the issued certificate. With the previous configuration file, we can execute this command for updating the existing ingress resources using the kubectl apply command. And at this point, we have if all is okay, we have configured our ingress resource. And once the ingress is created, there should be a TLS secret and a certificate created. And for validating this installation, for example, we can use the kubectl get certificates to see, for example, if our site, for example, our domain is using this configuration, accessing, for example, using HTTPS, that using a secure TLS connection. Well, once the certificate has been created successfully, you can run the scribe command to confirm that it was was created successful. This confirms that the TLS certificate was successful and HTTPS encryption is now active for the configured domains. Well, at this point, I'm going to resume the previous process in a state diagram. For example, of the previous process can be resumed in the following diagram that shows the life cycle of a certificate using the Let's Encrypt issuer. In the first step, as we have seen, a user creates a new certificate that references the Let's Encrypt issuer. In the second step, the key manager creates a temporary private key that references a secret, which is assigned to the certificate. In the process of creating this certificate, the request manager creates a certificate request object and syncs the certificate using the private key generated in the previous step. And once the certificate request has been created, the issuer creates an order object and creates one challenge per domain. This is what it does at low level, the certificate manager, for creating the certificate request, creating the challenge for the certificate, and so on. This is, in this area, it shows what is does cert manager at low level. In more, you can view what are the actions in more detail. At this point, Let's Encrypt works all the challenges and the issuer fetch the signed certificates from Let's Encrypt. Once the certificate request has been created, the information is copied in the certificate object by the cert manager. And in the last step, the controller sets the public key and copies the private key from the temporary secret object. And finally, the controller says the certificate object is ready with all the information. Basically, this is the resume for the process that certificate manager makes at low level for managing this all the information. Well, in this scenario, we can check a demo of the This is a scenario that provides Katakoda for testing this kind of features. Basically, in this demo, we can configure Vault as a certificate manager in the same way that we have used Let's Encrypt in this demo. Is using the Vault as a certificate management. basically we can follow with the steps that show here the information. For example, in this case, we are using Minikube for manage the Kubernetes cluster. Well, at this point, we have created our cluster. In the second step, we are installing the Vault help chart using the help report. Well, it looks like there is a problem installing Vault from the help repository. I'm not sure what is the problem here. Maybe the last version shows a parse error. It shows an error related that it can install this package. Maybe can be a bug in the last version, in the last release. I'm not sure. This part, if it doesn't work, well, we are going to the last step where we are configuring the Cert-manager. For example, here in the step 6, we are using the Jetstack Cert-manager for installing. Now we create a namespace. Cert-manager. This step, it looks like it works. And here we are updating the help and installing Cert-manager using the help instant command. At this point, we have installed the Cert-manager. We can verify that all the pods are available in the namespace we have created. At this point, we have created, it has created 3 pods running, 2 in running state and 1 in container creating. Now are the 3 running. In the next step, now we are going to create the issuer that I commented before using the create service account issuer. We get all the secrets in the default namespace. For example, we have the default token, the issuer token. With the following command, we can view the name of the user secret. And at this point, we create a configuration for our user. In this case, we are creating a user with this server. That's it. It's not a real server. It's a is a test. In this step, we create, now we continue creating the certificate using the this domain, example.com. If the previous step works with Vault, we can use the certificates for requests, for making the requests using this using these certificates from the Vault. And at this point, finally, we can see that the certificate is created with the domain example.com. And we can see that the state and here we can see the message generated a new private key and created a new certificate request resources. And at this point, we can see that has created the certificate. And that's all for my way. Finally, I will try to comment some conclusions. As conclusions, these are the conclusions. Basically, Cert-manager facilitates the certificate signing through the Kubernetes API. We create a certificate object. Cert-manager creates a private key. It syncs that key with that private key. Or interacts with the certificate authority to obtain the signature. The result is that it stores the resulting cert key plus cert in a secret resource. And finally, we have available a community user survey for Cert-manager. If you are using this tool, you can use this survey for give some feedback about your experience with this tool, and for give feedback to the CNCF project. And that's all. Thank you very much. If you have any question, you can do it. Thank you.